Hello, Abraham. Thank you just doesn't seem to be enough.
It isn't. But the vibration that is behind it is everything.
Thank you.
Words don't matter.
Thank you. I have two questions for you, and one has to do with getting comfortable with the idea of death and dying in order to really enjoy this life experience. And so I've really been focusing on that lately. And what I've recognized is that I've moved way beyond the fear. I've moved way beyond the heaven and hell, and I'm not afraid of that at all. I know that when I leave from this place, it will be just so beyond what I can imagine as far as good. But what I recognized is that I love my life, and so much of what I love about my life are the relationships that I have in my life. And so I recognize that my fear kind of death is not having those relationships in the way that I do now.
You're worried about you dying or them dying?
Me. And so I guess my question is, can you share what happens when we leave this physical body?
You know how when you wake up and suddenly Esther is feeling it strong lately because they've been in the different places so much. And so she will wake up and sometimes she will have to stop and think, where am I? And then she will say, I'm in the bus, but where is the bus? Is it in the garage at home? Is it parked on the cliff of Malibu? Are we halfway between San Antonio and Kansas City? Are we in Kansas City? Where am I? It takes a moment for the continuity of her life to, you know, that moment of readjusting as you awaken, that's about all the moment is as you awaken in non-physical. And then there is an immediate recognition of well-being and a super consciousness, the likes of which you have known every night that you've been sleeping, but you've forgotten every morning when you wake up. Only this time you wake up into it and know it. There is no loss of continuity and no not knowing who you are. But the knowledge of who you are is so much more than you have known before that there is a satisfaction that will wash over you and through you in a powerful way. For Esther, that waking up in the non-physical, where she will stay for a while, will be less emphatic or dramatic than for most people, because she's been letting that heaven's gate swing both ways, and as she's been allowing that broader perspective of self and source to flow into her as she is here. So depending upon how consciously aware you are of who you are and how consistently you're holding yourself in the vibration of well-being, there will be differing degrees of feeling of relief as you reemerge. But beyond that initial feeling of relief, the experience for all of you will be similar in that you will be wise beyond your human ability to perceive and in love with life in a way that defies anything that you know from your human perspective here. Okay. Some years ago, Jerry was in the back of a pickup truck with some children, and their father was driving the truck. And their father announced, as he loaded them all into the back of the truck, where Jerry was going to tutor them in Spanish as they drove, using a flashlight under the canopy, the father announced that the brakes on the truck had not been working for some time, but no problem, because he was able to manage the truck by gearing down. And so Jerry felt slight alarm, yes, at that. But then he realized that the man is putting his own children in the back of the truck, and so surely he must have some reasonable confidence that he can do what he says. And as they're coming down the mountain, Jerry hears this man attempting to gear down, and he can hear that the revolution of the engine is such that he cannot get it to mesh, and he is not able to gear it down. And Jerry knows that they are going too fast on this mountain ledge. And the man was wise. Instead of going off the cliff, he turned the truck into the side of the mountain, which caused it to roll up the side of the mountain and turn over. And it fell down on all of them. And Jerry remembers, he's telling the story to Esther and to us later, he remembers his knees and hands hitting the canvas top with the gravel beneath it and thinking, oh, that wasn't so bad. And then the truck fell on him and on them all, and he lost consciousness. And then regained consciousness, and no one was badly hurt. It all turned out just fine. But Jerry's awareness and his announcement to us and to Esther was, I am no longer afraid of death because now I know what death is. Death is alert, awake, alert, awake, alert, awake, not alert, and not awake. In other words, just finished, just over, it's done. And we said, that is nothing like what death is. Death is super consciousness. Death is not the end of thought. Death is super thought. Death is all-inclusive thought. Death is knowing who you really are. It's not an ending feeling. It's a beginning feeling. It's a euphoric feeling. It's a wholeness feeling. It's a love permeating feeling. It's a feeling of well-being that Esther cannot find adequate physical words to describe it. And we know that while we attempt it here, that you will not really know it until you die. And when you die, you'll really know it.
Can I communicate from that place? Like, you know, I think about my daughter, and I feel like I want to soothe her now.
Well, then say things to her such as this. You know, when I die, and I will, I'm going to be in a place of pure positive energy, and I'm going to be always aware of you. And I'm going to be chatting it up with you really good. And if you're sad because I'm dead, you won't be able to hear what I have to say. And I expect you to be sad for just a little while. In fact, I think 3 days of sadness is just about what I'd expect. Get back to me later on that. But for now, I'd like 3 days of intense mourning before you get back to your happy life again. Okay. But once you get back to your happy life, then begin to listen in, because I will be aware of you. I will be there for you. I will be insightful for you. We will have all kinds of humorous things together.
Oh, I love that.
Esther is having a wonderful time with her father. And the friend who has been traveling with Jerry and Esther recently made his transition. And one of the things that has been happening is he has been giving all of them signals, not Jerry and Esther so much, but his wife and his son and daughter. Dragonflies have been showing up in different places. And there is some intensity about the dragonflies that lets them know that it is their friend sort of sending them a signal and maybe peeping in on what they're doing. And so in San Antonio the other day, Jerry and Esther were having a medical practitioner's workshop, and they had an open house at the center and a party all afternoon on Friday. And so Esther and several people had been talking about their friend Ed, wondering if he was peeping in, because the gardens had been his creation and he loved them so. And so his name had come up here and here and here and here and here and here and here. And Esther was saying, oh, I want him to be here, and I feel that he surely must be, although she had not had any strong personal indication of it. And now Jerry is out in the garden, and he is talking with daughter Tracy and standing in the food line, and here comes a dragonfly, the first one that they have seen in this garden, the first one that Jerry and Esther had seen. And so Jerry points out to Tracy, there's the dragonfly, and we really think that that's Ed making his presence known. Although his presence is always there, it doesn't have to be made known, but isn't it fun when it is made known? And in the other room, inside the building, were Esther and friends and granddaughter Kate, all working with magic clay, and a very psychic woman is molding something that looks like it might be a butterfly, but not. And Kate said, what is that that you are making? And she said, it is a dragonfly. I don't know why I'm making a dragonfly. I just felt like making a dragonfly. And so what we're getting at is that all kinds of things like that begin to happen. And as you are looking for them and aware that there is potential for them and understanding that there is not death, that there is still consciousness, and you're watching for opportunities for the consciousness to intertwine, it happens more and more and more and more and more and more and more. Okay. There is no reason whatsoever that you should ever be separated from anyone that you've ever known. Your relationships are eternal.
Good.
Good time for a segment of reflection. Yeah.